Wow, what a group. Hey, it's such an honor to be here and especially to speak in this slot. You know, the speaker who speaks right before Robert Kiyosaki is a big, important speaking slot. Wouldn't you agree? In fact, it's such an important slot that the organizers have a committee to pick the most appropriate speaker for this slot, the last speaker before Robert Kiyosaki. And in this committee, you should hear what happened. They said, for this spot in Amsterdam, let's make sure to get a best-selling author. Let's get somebody who's influenced millions with his books. They phoned that person. Person said no. So they said, if we can't get a best-selling author, then let's for sure get a speaker who is one of the best motivating, exciting speakers on the planet. Somebody who knows how to get the audience excited before Robert Kiyosaki comes out. Are you excited about Robert? So they said, let's get at least, if we can't get the best-selling author guy, let's make sure to get the guy who is, you know, one of the funniest, one of the most exciting speakers in the world. And they phoned that person. Person said no. So then they said, if we can't get the best author, if we can't get the best speaker, let's make sure to get the most good-looking speaker. So they phoned that speaker. That speaker said, no, he can't come. So you want to know why I'm here? I'm here because I didn't have the heart to turn them down four times in a row. So I am going to talk about publishing a book. But you know, this slot is tough, eh? Just imagine being in this slot speaking after all of these speakers, huh? It's not easy. You've been listening to speaker after speaker after speaker. I feel a little bit like, let's turn the slides on. I feel a little bit like Elizabeth Taylor. Her ex, she had eight husbands. I feel a little bit like that eighth husband. He had a problem on his honeymoon, I'll tell you that. I feel a little bit like him, like I know exactly what I'm supposed to do, but I'm not sure how to make it interesting for you, but I'm going to do my best. All right, I want you to turn to page 94 in the workbook. There is some work sheets that you're going to be able to work through by being here, and I want to walk you through some of those slides. So I did write a book called The Millionaire Mindset. It's currently being translated. I spend a lot of time in South America. I go there raising money for a school in Barranquilla where we feed 500 poor, destitute children every day, breakfast and lunch. And thank you. If you ever were going to applaud, now would be the time. And we give them education from kindergarten to grade 12. And I go do seminars down there, and I leave all the money there. But the book is going to be translated in Spanish, and I'm thinking of doing this on the cover, huh? maybe not. So my next book is called Publish a Book and Grow Rich, and I'm going to talk to you about how you can do this, how anybody can do it, and if you have the right tools. Let me tell you that my approach is different from anything you have ever heard before. My approach is very opposite what you have probably heard. I believe that what you should do is publish your book yourself. That is, you write it, you print it yourself, you go to a printer, you publish it, and use it the way I'm talking about. I think you should stop trying to find a publisher. It's very difficult to find a publisher, and it takes forever. You will never be able to do with a publisher what I'm about to tell you right now and give you dozens of examples of people just like you who've published their books. I think you should focus on more than just book sales. There's not that much money in book sales, unless you're Robert Kiyosaki. But for most of us, you know, we can make $10 selling a 10 euro selling a book, but some of you can make 10,000 selling your product or service. That's where the money is, not in selling books. I'm going to talk to you about how you can get other people to pay for all of the cost. Is that of interest to you? So today I'm going to show you how average people can publish their books and have other people pay for all the costs associated with that. I'm going to be so different to tell you that not to bother selling your books in bookshops. I think it's a waste of time. It's not worth the effort in comparison to using the book the way I'm going to show you today. So if you look at a small book like this, look at this book. This is called Multiply Your Intelligence. Look how thin this book is. Just one sec. If we were to print this book, look how thick that is. This book I could print today in Amsterdam for less than 1 euro. Here, if you print 2,000 copies, you can get this book as a marketing tool. What you got to keep in mind is what the perceived value is for somebody receiving that book. So that's what I'm going to recommend. You know, if you spent, let's go turn the slides on. If you spent, say, 3,000, 4,000 euro to do this, to get the book ready, you print 2,000 copies, you can have between 30,000 and 40,000 retail value of books. That's what we call a good deal. So let me tell you that what I'm suggesting is that you not write a giant book. I think a 100-page book would be great for your first one. A simple book like this. 8 ways to be 10 times more motivated, or 7 questions to ask before you buy your next, and then you fill in what it is you sell. Something simple like that. So I'm going to show you these examples today, but I don't want it to go to your head. You see what happens to some authors when they become authors, their ego takes over, like this guy.
Wow.
Wow ist richtig, denn bei
Okay, we don't want to do that. Hey, turn the slides off for a second. Let me tell you my story. Can I do that? So I met a mentor 25 years ago, and he changed my life completely. This guy asked me one question and made 2 statements. That one question and those 2 statements put me on a whole new course of life. His question to me was, how much is the most amount of money you have earned in a single year? Well, I'm from Canada. Hey, not the U.S., There's a big difference. I'm from Canada, and we don't talk about money like that, but he was there to help me make more money, and so I answered the question that I had earned the year before, $100,000. Which I thought was pretty good, because nobody in my family had made this kind of money. None of my friends had made this kind of money. I grew up in poverty. My family was supported by the state. My parents couldn't even provide the basics of life, like a home and food, without government assistance. And so here he was asking me, and so because I had done my best year ever, I had just graduated. I was a former minister. My life turned around when I was 18, and I became a minister. And after I left seminary, I wrote my first book, and my whole life took off. And so I thought I was doing really good with 100. Then he made the first of 2 statements. His first statement to me was, 100,000 in a year, that's garbage, he said. And I thought to myself, how could you say that? And then he finished that sentence, and listen to this. He said, it's garbage for you to make that much in a year if you could make that much in a month. In a month. I was working like a dog to make that much in a year, and this guy was telling me I could make this in a month? I didn't say to him, okay, great guru, just tell me what to do. I did what was natural to me, which was if somebody shared an idea with me that was outside of my belief system, outside of my box, outside of my programming, I did what was natural, and you may have done the same thing. I started to fight with him. I started to argue with him. I gave him every reason in the world why I could never earn that much money in a single month. So as I'm telling him these reasons, like I'm young, I was only in my 20s when this happened. I told him that our country, Canada, was in the middle of a major recession. I told him that I didn't have any money. Some of you entrepreneurs know this, huh? I was making 100, but I was spending 125 to get it. And so as I'm telling him all these reasons why I could never earn $100,000 in a single month, and I'm telling him that I'm young and that I come from poverty and our country's in a recession and I don't have any money, he made the second statement. It was worse than the first. This guy looked at me right in the eye and said, as I'm arguing with him, "You are a jerk." Just like that. I didn't mean to look at you, sir, when I said that. But if somebody calls your income garbage and you a jerk in the first 5 minutes of meeting them, it's either going to be a pretty brief meeting or maybe you should shut up and listen. I thought to myself, what if he's right? What if it was possible to earn in 1 month what I used to earn every year? Heck, at that time, I wasn't thinking every month. I was just thinking once, if I could do it 1 month, earn in 1 month what I earned in a year. Can you imagine what that would be like? Next month, earning what you earned all last year? Because I kept thinking, what if it was right? What if it was right? Not about the jerk part either. I knew that wasn't true. So I decided to follow this man's advice. He said, what you got to do is get out of your own way. You got to start thinking differently. And if he told me to do something, I did it. How many of you are going to follow advice that you're learning here this weekend? Let me see your hands. We'll see. So I decided to follow him. 12 months later, I was earning. 12 months later, I started to make every month what I used to make every year. I started to make over $1 million a year when I was in my 20s. And life is different when you're making that kind of money. How many of you like to have something like that happen to you? Okay. Well, you know, in the past 25 years, I've been able to put over $100 million into my bank account and that of my partners by using the things that I'm going to talk to you about today. So how many of you are ready? Say, I. Okay. Before I do that, because some people ask me, if you make so much money, why do you travel the world? How many of you here want to be speakers? Oh, tons of you. But if you do speaking now, you know I don't have to do this, but I have to do this. You know what I'm talking about? People say, well, what's the alternative? Do I stay home and retire? Look, this is what I would be doing if I was retired. This is how I'd spend my days. All right. You don't want me retired. So I started to think differently. Let me ask you here in Amsterdam, are you a thinking audience today? Are you a thinking audience? See, that was a piss poor response, guys. Here's what's going to happen. I'm going to enthusiastically ask the questions, and you're going to enthusiastically answer the questions. Yeah. Right? Yeah. Good. Because if you don't, I give you psychological tests right from here. I can find out if you're thinking. Do you want to take my test? Go like this. Everybody, make a circle like this with your hand. Quick, everybody. One, two, three, put it on your chin. Go. Go. Chin. Your chin's down here. Oh, my goodness. Some of you aren't thinking. Okay, I got a second test. Okay, this second test is by Harvard University, Department of Psychology. Very quickly, and then we'll start talking about books. Are you okay? Okay, everybody, go like this. Put your hands like this. And when I say go, I want you to clasp your hands and leave them like this, okay? One, two, three, go. Okay, leave them like this. Hey, psychological studies show that if your left hand, your left thumb is on top, you're a thinker. Okay, hold on. If your right thumb is on top, you're motivated by sex. Hey, get this. One more piece of information. If your hands are like this, if you went like this, you just think you're sexy. Okay. I want you to quickly turn to the next page. I want you to go to page 60 and ask you to do something. Shh. Hey, would you agree that my mentor asked me to do things that didn't make sense to me at the time? Do you think that a mentor does that? Well, that's what happened to me. He gave me advice that I and suggestions, and I did them even though it doesn't make sense. I'm going to give you one of those right now. I'm going to ask you to do something that's not going to make sense to you, but I want you to do it anyway. How many of you are willing to follow my advice even though it doesn't make sense? Say yes. Okay, so here's what I'm going to do. How many of you think that I'm going to try and sell you something at the end of the seminar? I promise not to disappoint you. But hold on. Let me tell you why I do that. I'm from Canada, and we like to know at the start what the guy's going to try and sell me at the end. Okay? But here's my advice. I'm going to do something that no speaker has ever done at the National Achievers Congress. I'm going to do something that's going to blow your mind at the end of the seminar. But here's my advice. I'm going to suggest you take that page and gently rip it out of your manual. Do it now. Here's why I'm going to ask you to do it. Be very careful. Just quickly, carefully, just pull it out. Carefully. Okay, now I need you to listen why I'm doing this. Because I'm going to do something at the end of today's seminar that no other speaker has done that I promise is going to blow your mind. But if you're not ready, you'll miss the opportunity. So I'm going to suggest during my talk you start filling it in. If you fill it in and you don't want to come to my seminar, then don't hand it in. But isn't it better to be prepared and not need something than to need something and not be prepared? Does that make sense? And then I'm not going to talk about my seminar until a few minutes at the end. Is that a good exchange? Okay, let's get started. First thing I want to tell you is that all of these books that you see here are people who are in seminars just like this. They're not writer types. They're not people who want to be best-selling authors. They're entrepreneurs. Most of them are terrible spellers. They're good at their business, and they want a tool to brand themselves differently. There's nothing as powerful as using something like this as your calling card. Nothing. What is this, by the way? It's not a book. It's a brochure on steroids. That's what this is. So I want you to know that the people who you see here are not people who are any different than you. That's who I speak to. But I want to show you this. How many of you have been thinking about writing a book? Let me see your hands quickly. Hi. Keep your hands up if you've been thinking about it for more than 5 years, more than 10 years, more than 15. Your hands aren't stuck, are they? How long have you been thinking about it? 16 years. Man, I'm going to depress you so much today. When you see how much money you're leaving on the table by not having this book, you're going to be very depressed. Now, what stops people? You got to ask yourself, almost everywhere I go, same percentage of people, they almost all want to write a book. They don't do it. Let me tell you the reasons that I have found why people don't publish the books. One of the biggest ones is they're worried about what other people think. We already proved that most other people don't think. You know, one of the things that you have to struggle with, maybe I can tell you this because I had to struggle with it, is what your family's going to think if you put your picture on a cover of a book. I said to my brother, let me show you my brother. I said to him in my 20s, I'm writing a book. He said, you can't write a book. I said, why not? He said, you're illiterate. I said, I am not illiterate. He said, you can't write a book. He said, you're illiterate. I said, I'm not illiterate. Mom and dad were married when I was born. Some of you will get that joke on the way home. So I think if you look at this quick little video, the black cat represents the obstacles that you've had to writing your book. What I do is I help people, and by the end of today, you'll have the power to go through that obstacle. So whatever your reason for not publishing a book, let it be represented by that black cat. And then it's there, and it looks scary, and then it stops you from doing what you want to do. Then all of a sudden, Jerry comes along, bam! See, the problem is, you think you got to write a book like this. This, by the way, is a book published here in Amsterdam called What Dutch Men Know About Women. And all the pages are blank. You see, the problem is, watch the screen. You think you have to write a book that's world-changing, earth-shattering, industry-revolutionizing, personality-altering, history-making book, incomprehensibly complicated work of art that's totally original with never-before-heard-of content, a massively-sized book that's masterfully written in perfect English, a one-of-a-kind book without one single spelling mistake. The reality is you don't have to worry about any of those things if you do it the way I'm talking about. So, are you ready to open the door to how you can self-publish your own book?
Yes.
Okay, I'm going to open the door, but it won't be quite like this guy. All right. All right, let's get going. Step number one, look at how much publicity this plastic surgeon has received just from publishing his book. He attended my seminar. Look at, he has had tremendous publicity. Why? Because he understood the first step, which is to determine your primary objective. What do you want the book to do for you? So you got to ask yourself, before you write any content, what is it that you want to receive from this book? Not what the reader is going to receive, but what are you going to receive? You want to generate leads, you want differentiation, you want to recruit more people or have credibility. Ask yourself these things and determine one main objective. Let me show you some examples. So this lady wrote a small book called Happy Kids. Now look how thick that is. Don't tell me you couldn't write a book like this. She writes this little book to build her coaching business. She became a life coach. She used to advertise in the newspaper before she met me, before she did this. She was getting about 15 to 20 calls a week from her newspaper ad. I said to her, why don't you offer the book for free in the newspaper? Costs less than €1 to do this. She offered the book for free in a newspaper ad. She went from 15 calls to 500 by offering a free copy of the book. You see, it's a great magnet for those of you who are looking to generate more leads. It's phenomenal for that. Here's another thing that it'll do for you. This guy's a renovator. He used the book to change people's perception of his business because most people don't think very highly of renovators. He stood up in Australia last time I was there and said his book, he directly attributes over $2 million because he could use his book to change the view of customers for his renovation business. This lady from Australia was a stay-at-home mom. She always wanted to do speaking but could never get herself booked. She writes this book and now she's completely book solid. You cannot be a public speaker or a professional speaker without a book. Step number two, write the right content. So you don't have to write a big thick book. You just got to decide you're going to do it, and it doesn't have to be earth shattering. You don't have to have totally new content. In fact, this author is an accountant. What he did was, you know, all the jokes that were passed around the internet? He compiled those and put them in a book, and he uses the book to get speaking to do humorous lecturing in the evening. Can I read you one of his jokes? So this is Little Johnny. Little Johnny was playing on the street when he spots a package of Viagra pills. Being a boy of the world, he immediately recognizes the possibilities and he approaches his father. Hey, Dad, I found these pills of Viagra here. I'll sell them to you for $100. Son, while that may be a very good offer, I'm in perfect physical health and not currently needing those. Tell you what, go and ask Grandpa. So he goes across the street and says, Gramps, I'll sell you this package of Viagra pills for $100. Grandpa says, gee, I don't know. Do you think that they'll work for me? And the young boy says, well, I don't know, but they look like the same ones that were on TV. So Grandpa says, tell you what, I'm going to try them tonight, and if they work, I'll give you $100 tomorrow. The next morning, Johnny comes back, and Grandpa gives him $500. But Gramps, I thought we agreed to $100. He said, that's okay, Johnny, keep it. The rest is from Grandma. So you see, his objective was to write a book to get him speaking engagements in the humorous realm. I did a test in network marketing. I wanted to see if book could help build a network marketing business. I was in network marketing for 1 month. I wanted to see what the test would be. I chose a company called Niken. It was there for 30 years. I'm not in the company. I'm in no networking company, although I endorse networking as an industry. So I said, I wonder if it would work. And instead of using the same techniques everybody else used, I used my book as a way to recruit. The record for personal volume in 1 month in that 30-year-old company was 117,000 by one guy named Mike DiMuccio. And Mike had been with the company for 11 years at that time when he broke the last record, when he broke the record, when he set that record. And he was a grand poopah, diamond, you know, big cheese in the company. The most he sold in 1 month was 117. In my first month, that's the check I got because I sold $253,000 the first month. And so I share that with you because there's some network marketers in here, is there? Well, I don't know what your first check looked like, but if you have the right tools, it can be huge. And so what I want you to do is to think about what you want the book to do for you and then write a book that's appropriate to that task. So people say, but I'm not an expert. How could I write a book? You don't have to be. You don't have to be an expert at all. Turn the slides off for a second. Look at that little book cover. Listen to me for a sec. This guy was 20 years old. He wrote a book called The Millionaire Genius. At the time, he was in network marketing. He had just entered network marketing. He was 27 years old. He was 22 years old, and he was making $27,000 a year. I said to him, write a book called The Millionaire Genius. Who would be attracted to that? The exact same people who'd be attracted to network marketing, right? He said, how can I possibly write a book called The Millionaire Genius? He said, I only make $27,000 a year. I said, do this. Go and interview other people who are wealthy. Ask them what their advice is. You be the reporter and put that in a book. Let's go back to the slides for a second. If you think about this for a second, does that guy look broke to you? He used that book, and now Dave doesn't earn $27,000 a year. He earns $27,000 a month. And he uses this book as a phenomenal tool, even though when he wrote it, he didn't know very much about money. What he did know about is how to research and be a reporter and go and find out what other people said about his topic. Here's another reason that some of you struggle. Is you struggle because you think that there's too many books on the subject. And would anybody want another book? Is there room for another book on the subject that you're thinking about? And the answer is categorically yes. We're not going to try and put them in the bookstores and knock and compete on the bestseller list. That's not the kind of publishing I'm recommending. I'm talking about entrepreneurial publishing. Publishing that gives you a chance to raise your credibility, to brand you as an authority. I'm talking about using a book as a marketing tool, as one that you would give away. I give away more books than I sell. Now, the ones that I sell pay for the ones that I give away, but there's a lot more money in selling your services than selling a book. And if you're talking about using a book the way I'm talking about, where you autograph a book and you give it directly to a prospect, they're never going to say, oh, there's already lots of books on that. I don't want that. They would never say that. So let go of that. If there's a lot of books on your topic, we call that a clue. Step number three, design an awesome cover. You see, your book is your representation. And there are some people who publish self-published books, or they go to gurus who've never made $100 million in this industry, and they give them a book cover that looks like crud. You need to design a book cover. Look at this guy came to this seminar with this cover. This was his book. I said, has it helped you much? He said, no, hasn't helped me very much at all. I turned it into that. What do you think? I'm not sure about this one, but I think this one's better. Do you agree? Yes. I'd say, I agree. Keep you awake. Look at some of these titles that we have recently published through our publishing company from people who were at the seminar just a few weeks ago. This is a financial planner. Imagine going to a networking meeting with something like this. Check out that cover. She's a medical doctor from England. Another network marketer talking about how you can control your money and wealth. So on page 97, I won't go through the whole thing there. On page 97 are all the various things that go into making a good cover. So you go through each point and you use this as a guideline or a checklist before your book, you accept your book cover. And you notice I'm suggesting you get your book cover, a JPEG, just like this. You get a JPEG like this before you write one word. See, once you have this cover, I'm going to show you how you can improve your income within 2 weeks of getting that cover. You should use humor too, huh? And just in case some of you are wondering, no, that is not me in the picture there. Somebody said it was your body shape. I don't know about that. How about that cover? It's a hot topic in this city, I hear. I got to tell you a quick story, the golf bags there. I was thinking about this last night. Now, I'm coming back here in a few weeks, and my wife is coming with me. And that just about 2 weeks ago, we celebrated our 30th wedding anniversary. Isn't that cool? But last night, I was thinking, you know. I phoned her up, and I asked her a question. I said, Ann, if I died, would you marry some other guy? Guys, this is a dumb question. Never ask your wife that question. She said to me, if you did die, Jerry, would you want me to marry some other guy? I said, you're young, you're beautiful, it would be okay. Now I can't stop thinking about it, huh? It's driving me crazy. So I phoned her back and I said, if I did die and you married that guy, would he live in this house, in our house? She said, would you want him to? I said, yes, I suppose that would be okay. And now I'm getting even more frustrated and more frustrated. And guys are so stupid sometimes, they should shut up, but they don't shut up. There's the women. Let's hear it from the women. She says, so I said to her, because it's really bothering me now, huh? I said, Ann, I need to know the answer to the ultimate question. She says, what's that? Would that guy use my golf clubs? You know what she said? No. He's left-handed. They would never work. Oh. Man. Jeez, I want to get home now. All right, the next step is to set your business up to capture leads before you do anything else. And what I mean by that is you set up a one-page squeeze page or landing page or opt-in page. See, one of the strategies we recommend, if you're an author, lots of people will view you differently than everybody else who does what you do. In fact, one of the greatest benefits of being an author is that you're separated from the thousands of other people who do exactly what you do. And so, because of that, and you have all this credibility, I suggest you offer a free downloadable version of your book on a squeeze page. Now, I'm not talking, I like the word downloadable version rather than ebook, but even though your book may not be ready for 6 months, and you should never take longer than 6 months, even though your book may not be ready for months, you start offering it for free, a downloadable version, and you tell them the book's not going to be out till January or February, but you tell them if they give you their name and information, you then will be able to give them the book once it comes, once it's finished. If you're in marketing or you're an entrepreneur, you better see the value of that. If somebody goes to your website and asks for your downloadable version of your book based on a topic that you solve in your business, what you have there is a very hot prospect. So most people tell me, if I could just get in front of enough people, if I could just, you know, attract them, I'll sell them, because you're good at selling. The challenge most of you have is you're not good at pulling them. So a book, because it has a high perceived value in our culture, is a phenomenal tool to make people come to you. And so I recommend that you use a one page like this. It has a video in the center. Now, you have to use a video these days. I recommend a 30-second high-definition video. I'm going to show you her example. She came to our seminar, and she's used the book tremendously. So you put the video on there, and you offer what the book is. Watch. This video is only 30 seconds long. This is the purpose of the video, is to make people come to you and leave you their name and number. So watch the call to action at the end. Thank you. So she was able to get like thousands of people, prospects, go to her website, give her her name, and build a database. Every speaker here is going to tell you that the money's in the database. All right. So you want to capture the leads by creating one of these pages. Now, before I tell you the next step, I want to show you another quick little commercial, but I was thinking of my wife again. Can I share one more story about my wife? No, seriously, can I share one more story? Okay, so when my kids were young, I used to travel a lot. One time I was gone for 20 days, 21 days. I come back from the airport usually after going away for 2 weeks. And we have three boys, huh? Does anybody here have three boys? Anybody have four boys? No, they never go out. So my wife takes care of these kids. So when I get to the airport, she usually has had enough of these kids, huh? Except this one time, I came back from the airport. She's smiling from ear to ear. And I'm saying, why are you so happy? I've been gone for 21 days. My young son picked up a hamster cage, huh? And he says, Mom started a hamster farm while you're away to help deal with the stress. Okay, if that floats your boat. So she's going to start breeding hamsters, huh? So I said to her, well, that's interesting. If that's going to help you, I give you, it's great. My other son said, Dad, there are three hamsters in this cage. Two males and one female. I don't know anything about breeding animals, but isn't it usually the other way around? Don't you need two males or two females for every male when you're breeding animals? At least. So I turned to her and I said, you don't need two males then. She says, you do if one travels all the time. Watch this commercial.
Zazu condoms.
All right.
Fun, sexy, sexy.
All right, step number five. I'm going to show you how to use a book to boost your sales. Look at this guy's an insurance salesman. If he shows up with that, or if he sends that to his prospects before he has the call, imagine how his life's going to be different. Now, this guy could barely speak English. He's not a very good, English is not his first language. He came to me and he said, I could never write a book. I'm brand new in insurance. He said, I'm a terrible speller and I'm not a good writer. But if you tell me a book's going to help me boost my sales, he says, I'll do it. And so he writes this book. And now just imagine what he does with this book. He autographs it like this before he makes a sales call. He autographs the book. My mentor told me to give my book to the most positive people in this city. I hear you're one of them. Looking forward to meeting you next Tuesday at 5. What do you think that does to the perception of the customer in terms of their view of him as an insurance salesman? Totally different. And so I want to show you how to use a book to build your sales. Let me just talk about the logic behind it. Are people, consumers, less skeptical or more skeptical of those of us who try and sell them things? Less or more? Are they less trusting or more trusting? A lot less trusting. They demand more. They're skeptical. They tend to push away. And so if you use the same marketing material as everybody else, if you try and manipulate customers, if you miss the opportunity to separate yourself from everybody who does what you do, you're going to have a tough time in sales. Now, what most people do, this is estate agents in Canada and US, see, they put a business card, they have their picture, the logo. Now, some people think they're smart by putting an odd-shaped card, and she puts a cartoon instead of a picture of herself. So that's how she differentiates herself in the marketplace. Look at what our guys do. That's what they use as a marketing card, as a calling card, as a way for them to have a position of authority. And anybody can do this. It's almost like people are waiting for somebody on high to give them permission to use a tool like this in their business. It's like they're waiting for God to say something like, hey, remember I told you earlier that I'm a former minister? Do you remember that? Some of you are looking at me like deer on a highway right now. I need you to respond. Do you remember me saying that?
Yes.
So you're waiting for somebody on high, and I'm a former minister. Everybody look at me. Everybody? Okay, I give you permission. You can write the book now. Go ahead and do it. So here's one of the techniques that you use. Before you write before your book comes out, you start making a list of prospects. These are people that are hard for you to get into. You know, they've got these evil people called gatekeepers, and they prevent you from going in there. Or if you want to if you want to meet a prospect, phone them up and ask them if you could interview them for your upcoming book, because you want the book to be very practical. And you want to have people who are in the trenches. You could do this to any prospect that you're going after right now, and the door will be open real wide. This lady, Mary Beth Haynes, is a customer service representative. She wrote this book about grieving pet loss, you know, once a pet dies. She made 73 calls and got 69 interviews. Those 69 interviews have generated close to $30,000 for her in book sales, and the book's not even out. $30,000 in book sales, and she has a contract into one of those persons she interviewed for $200,000. Because once you're in there, I mean, let's face it, people are honored that you want to interview them for a book. They've never had that request before. And so you go in there, you ask them questions about the industry, about the trends, mistakes people make, things to avoid. And what you do is you write about them in your book. It just might be a line or two. But because you've included them in the book, man, they think the world of you. If some of you want to penetrate a big company, go and interview the CEO or the MD. I'm telling you, she was able to interview people who are CEOs of, like in her case, the American Humane Society. And so there's a lot of things that you can do if you have a tool like a book to get an interview. You could give your book, for example, to famous people. This lady's from England, and I'm going there in a couple of days. She said, are you going to come to my book launch party? I said, well, I'll come if the Queen shows up. I was just kidding, huh? She sent a copy to the Queen. Now, this lady who wrote this book was a trauma victim. She'd been abused as a child. And when she gave a copy of the book to the Queen, she talked about that in her letter. And she invited the Queen to come to her book launch party. And she got a letter back from the Queen. Let me read one part of it. The last sentence says this. The Queen was interested to read about the reasons behind the writing of your book, and thought it kind of you to give her a copy as a gift. What do you think that did to her coaching business? She's been all over the press throughout England simply because she was able to give her book to a famous person. The next thing is to get publicity. A book is a phenomenal tool to get publicity. Now, the toughest thing I have to overcome for you is the belief that anybody would want to interview you. And I say that because that's what happened to me. When I was in my mid-20s, I was absolutely broke, but I had written a book. And I recognized early on that if you talk to the media about a book, they'll give you attention. Even though I didn't know anything from anything. I got kicked out of school when I was 15. I was happy when they made that choice. But if I could get interviewed in my 20s with no experience, no written material, then why couldn't you? This lady wrote this small little book called Protect Yourself, or Stop Singing the Blues. Look how thick that is. She was featured in Time magazine before her book actually came out. This is a pharmacist in my local town. His book isn't even out. Look at the press he got. This next guy is Odman Berger from Finland, from Oslo. He's a network marketer. Look at the size of the article that was written with about him in the national newspaper because he wrote a book. He's just a salesman. He's just a recruiter. He's just in network marketing, but look at the publicity he gets. So I'm telling you that if you have a book, you can get a lot of publicity. The next step is how to get other people to pay for absolutely everything. Are y'all still with me? So step number 7 says that it's possible for you to raise money to pay for all the costs, because it costs money to print the book and do the marketing materials and the website. Let me show you what happened. I also came up with the idea that you could make money before you write one word. Do you like that idea? So this lady who wrote this book called Mad Dogs and Crazy Cats, it's about how men are like dogs and women are like cats. I don't know the whole concept, but after she attended my seminar, she came up to me and she gave me a giant hug, and I said, "What's that all about?" And she said, "You wouldn't believe what happened to me last night." I said, "What happened?" She says, "I was at a women's networking meeting. And you know how they let you come up for 2 minutes and share your business?" She said, "I took a JPEG of my book cover, like you said, and I had an order form on every seat. And I told them that my book was coming out in 6 months, but here's what it was going to be about. But if they bought a copy tonight, I would give them a free coaching session." She said, 171 people bought the book. 5,100 is in my bank account, she said. She said, "The most I've ever made in a month was 3,600. And yesterday I made 5,100. So I said to her, "How is the book coming, Ann?" She puts her head down. "I haven't started yet." Of course, if you take money from somebody, you know, the law requires you to finish the book, right? Y'all know that. Lots of places in this world where you buy things that are going to be built in the future. Many of you bought houses that way. You pay a deposit and then you get the thing later. Now, the thing is, if you take money, you have to produce the book. But if you take money, you will actually finish the book. Why couldn't some of you use all kinds of techniques to be able to pre-sell your book? We had one person the other day, got an email, pre-sold 600 copies of his book, raised $25,000, and his book isn't even finished. Here's another thing that you could think about. One thing you could do is sell ads in the back of your book. So we get people raising $20,000, $30,000, $50,000, $60,000, $75,000 by selling ads in the back of the book. Now, I'm not talking about tons and tons of ads. I'm talking about, look at 5 or 10, 15 ads. You get people to agree to buy 100 copies of your book. And what you do is you go find people who do not compete with you, but who also want to get in front of your readers. Now, this lady was able to, like I say, generate $35,000 by selling ads, and she pulled the money in before the book was even out. How many of you think that's a good idea? Say, aye! Here's another interesting thing. This lady here, she was a financial advisor. She wrote a book called Protect Yourself. Her market was senior citizens. I said to her, "Why don't you find a law firm and offer them the opportunity to submit a chapter in your book, and we'll call it a bonus chapter, and charge them $7,500 for that privilege?" They were lined up to pay her. Why? Because she's writing a book for senior citizens on how to protect themselves financially. They're a law firm that likes to do business and go after senior citizens. And so there was a natural fit for them. They paid her $7,500. There are people who are going, who are currently advertising and spending money trying to go after the same people you're trying to go after. Partner with them to fund this whole thing and boost your income. And all you need to do that is a copy of your cover, a good title, and a JPEG of your cover, and something we call a media kit, an advertising kit that shows them the benefits of advertising in your book. It's a phenomenal tool. Okay, step number eight. You gotta decide to do it. Now, most people don't understand how decisions are made. Most people fear making decisions because they want to make the right decisions. They're afraid to make the wrong decision, so they make no decision, which is a decision. In Think and Grow Rich, Napoleon Hill said that people who were wealthy learned how to make decisions quickly and rarely changed their mind. People who are broke take forever to make a decision, and then once they do make a decision, they change their mind all the time. So I'm suggesting when you're here and you have the thought of writing a book, publishing your own book, you're going to have things happen in your head that may sound a lot like what my mentor told me I could do, make in 1 month what I used to make in 1 year, and I was fighting him because it was outside of my paradigm. Some of you listening to me right now have the same paradigm issue. You're saying, how could that be? I'm saying, just make a decision. I'm going to do this. No matter what, I'm going to do this. Does that make sense to you? Okay, so I need you to help me. I'm going to start talking about my seminar, but before I do that, I need you to help me out with one thing. Will you help me out? Yes. I need 10 times more enthusiasm. Will you help me out? Yes. So when I count to three, when I count to three, I want you to all stand up, and I want you to yell and scream, make as much noise as you can, just for 3 to 5 seconds, and when I count to three, you get up and do that enthusiastically. Yes? Yes. 1, 2, 3, up. Come on. Please be seated. Let me tell you why I did that. I'll tell you why I did it. Because I was out back there this morning, and the lady came up to me. I won't look at her, but she's in this room. She looked at me and she said, see, whenever they do this with the hip, you know you're in trouble. She said, oh, so you're Jerry Robert, huh? One of the speakers. She said, are you any good? And I said to her, ma'am, this is Success Resources. I said, man, they've got Robert Kiel. You see the caliber of speakers. I said, am I any good? I said, I flew all the way from Canada to be here. I'm on every stage they do. I said, I'm the last speaker before Robert Kiyosaki comes out. Am I good? I said, I'm really good. And I said to her, I bet you before the finish of my talk, I'm going to get a standing ovation from the audience here. All right. So, can I take a few minutes and talk to you about my seminar? Hey, by the way, if any of you would like a copy of these slides, just don't steal them and start competing with me. But if you want, just go to this URL and you can download these slides. Some people want them; they ask for them all the time. So, just go to that URL. And this talk is called 8 Steps. You're able to download those slides. Thank you, yes, thank you, you're welcome. Oh, put it back, ah. tinyurl.com, download my slides. Okay, got to make you laugh for a quick second, then we'll talk about my seminar. Watch this.
Daddy's going to make you laugh now. Ready?
All right, she's got four boys. Okay, I'd like you to take up the sign-up sheet. I want you to fill in, just highlight some things. The seminar that I'm doing, and I'm going to go through this very quickly, folks, so just stay with me, and I promise I'm going to do something that's going to blow your mind. Remember my advice. If anything resonated from what I said today, and how many of you learned a few things? It resonated? Good. Start filling out that sheet. Put your name and your address, your phone number on there. I promise you in a minute, you're not going to believe what I'm going to do. So I'm coming here in 33 days from today. All the information is there. Our seminar is a Friday night, all day Saturday, and all day Sunday. When you come to the class, we give you a large workbook, a seminar workbook. We start about 7 p.m. on Friday and go till about 11, Saturday all day, Sunday all day. Our program is built on 5 modules that you need to have if you're going to use a book in the entrepreneurial fashion that I'm talking about. Let me go through them quickly. On Friday night, we help you plan it, get the right book. See, you need to find out which book that you should do first. How many of you have more than one book in you? See, there's one book that'll make more money for you than the other. And so I help you show you how to find the fastest path to the biggest cash. On Saturday morning, I've got a system called Write It, where we show you how to write a book in 40 hours. How many hours? 40 hours. You're not going to believe this system, but some of you who've had writer's block and have a hard time getting the book out of your head, by Friday at noon, you'll know how to write a book just like that. You'll never have a problem again. Now, all of these books that you see here, and I could have 100 tables just like it, there's not one person on this planet who is responsible for publishing more people's books than me. I've been doing this for 25 years, and I can tell you that the system that they use is phenomenal, and you'll get that Saturday morning. On Saturday afternoon, we have systems called Fund It. So that's this whole thing related to using a book to boost your income, how to find other people to pay all the costs, how to sell ads in the back of your book, and why that makes so much sense. I give you the exact templates that we use, the Word documents. All you need to do is to change the documents. I bring people in who have actually raised $20,000, $30,000 selling ads in the back of the book. That's part of Fund It. Now, I want you to watch this short 30-second video. I was in Singapore a few months ago, and about a month after the class, I got this quick video from this young man. Listen to him. His name's Ranford.
Hi, Jerry. Just want to thank you for what you have taught me during the boot camp in March this year. To give you an update on my progress, to date, I've raised more than 15,000 Singapore dollars in terms of sponsorships and pre-sold more than 600 books, not 700, my mistake. But you know what the best part is? I've not even started working on my book yet. So what you really thought me is really amazing, and I'm still recovering from a state of shock, you know, that I'm able to raise such an amount. I'm only a 22-year-old still in national service. But like what you always say, when you collect the money, you gotta finish the book lah. So I'm working hard on it now. So I feel so excited for all the participants that will be attending your boot camp next week. They are definitely in for a treat. So hope to see you soon, Jerry. Bye.
Listen, if a 22-year-old could come to my seminar and raise $15,000 before he's written one word, don't tell me you can't do it. You can do it, and we show people all over the world how to use a book and fund it through these methods that I'm talking about that brings money to you before you write one word. Back to the slides, please. So on Saturday as well, we cover the Publish It section. And so we deal with all the things related to the publishing and ISBN numbers and where do you get it printed and what's the difference between soft cover and hard cover and what's copyright and plagiarism. We cover all that. Now Sunday, by the way, on Saturday as well, We show you how to get celebrity endorsements for your book. I had all these people plus 26 other pages of endorsements for my first book. And I was in my 20s. I was broke. I had no experience. I just found a system to help people get celebrities to endorse their book. If you're in network marketing and you've got a celebrity who says that you're a great guy or a great woman, what do you think that does for your credibility if that's on the back of your book? That's easy to do. I'm going to give you the actual letters that we used, that I used, to get all of these people to endorse my books. That's on Saturday afternoon. On Sunday, the whole day is devoted to moving it. You know, you've got to figure out what to do with the books once you get them. So that's what's all on Sunday. Jack Canfield, you know, from Chicken Soup for the Soul, friend of mine, he says it's 10% content, 90% marketing. So we're going to show you what to do to these books to help them boost your business, to brand your company like never before. All right, if you see on that sign-up sheet, there are four bonuses that we're giving away if you decide to come to my seminar. Let me go through them quickly. First bonus is we will design a book cover like that for you. 10 days after you attend the seminar, you'll have that JPEG and you'll know what to do with it to start building sales, building referrals, generating leads. I give you that bonus as part, and it's totally customized for your book. Remember that video I told you about? Once your book cover is done, we're going to give you a 30-second high-definition video to put on that page, and I'm even going to give you the code, the HTML code, for you to put up that will your own squeeze page, your own landing page, and you're going to put that video, we're going to put that video right in that page for you. We give you this, totally customized for you. The next bonus is 1 year of unlimited coaching. Something's not working, you have a big opportunity, you want to learn how to use the book to do speaking, to do more traveling, to do branding, you just let us know, we get back to you within 24 to 48 hours. The other thing is we give you a full home study course, which is the entire weekend that we have filmed in South Africa. We film the entire thing. You get all of that, access to that next week. It's all online. All of the videos, all of the worksheets, all of the samples of everything you need, you have access to this next week. I'm coming back here in 3 weeks. You could be well prepared on your way. I have a satisfaction guarantee. If you don't like the seminar, just tell us and we'll get you your money back. Now look at this for a second. If I was to charge individually for all these things, I don't think it's unreasonable to think that I could get this fee. If you sign up here, it's €2,499. Now let me ask you this. For $2,499 to get all of these bonuses, I think is a great deal for $2,499. Let me ask you this. If it was free, how many of you'd want it? The whole thing. Let me see your hands. Come on, let's make some noise. No, no, don't come up. Don't come up. There's too many people. There's too many people. Just hold on a second. I got one requirement. Watch this. I will let everybody in here who wants to come for free. How many of you are? Is it again? Let me see here. Oh man, we may have a problem. Here's what I want. Here's what you need to do. You need to follow this advice. Scratch out the price right now. Put free. And at the top, start filling out the information right away. Just start, don't come up here. Listen, there's way too many people. We'll have a riot. Fill out the top of the form. I'm going to show you what to do with it in 1 minute. Start filling it out. Now, I want you to put your hand, wave your paper if you'd like to come for free. Now, everybody else, keep waving. Look around the room. We got hundreds and hundreds of people. Hold on. Now I'm going to ask you, I have one requirement. Look at how many people are here. Listen up. I have one requirement. It's going to cost me a lot of money in printing to rent a room like this. So I have one requirement. You pay €49 to help defray the costs, okay? The tuition is completely free. Don't do anything. Stop. The tuition is completely free.